Hi everyone, Zach Reinhardt here for CTBoost.com, and I'm very excited to introduce you to the Cubic Worlds online course for Blender 3D. In a nutshell, this course teaches you how to create stunning low-poly animations using the free 3D tool Blender for intermediate users. As 3D artists, we dream of telling our stories in beautiful 3D animations. However, the more we dive into the world of 3D, the more we learn that creating stunning 3D animations is a very complex and time-consuming task. From coming up with an idea to arriving at a final 3D animation can sometimes take weeks, months, or even years. Also, 3D tools like Blender offer endless possibilities on how to tell our stories in 3D, from super stylized to photorealistic, from simple animations to feature films. On the one hand, this is great. However, having too many options can prevent us from getting started in the first place and block our creativity. With Cubic Worlds, we are going for a simplified LEGO approach. LEGO, for example, gives us a limited amount of elements to work with, but with these limited elements, we can basically create anything we can imagine. So we are limited in a certain way, but this helps us to be more creative much faster because we don't have unlimited options. In Cubic Worlds, we do it in a similar fashion. We will only work with cubes. That means the entire scene, each and every visible 3D object is created out of a cube-like shape, meaning the basic geometry which we will use is a cube with six sides, which we then deform in any possible way. In terms of complexity, it's again similar to LEGO. We can go with big LEGO Duplo bricks, which allows even the smallest kid to build something, but we have also smaller LEGO bricks for older kids or LEGO Technic for more experienced LEGO builders. The same way it also works in Cubic Worlds. We can go very simple by creating a tree out of two cubes, for example, or we go a bit more crazy. It's totally up to you. Also in 3D, we usually start with the modeling phase. We are creating our 3D objects, and this usually happens with a gray material. So we are constantly looking at a gray, boring scene. This is not very exciting, and we are totally disconnected from how the final result will look like while we are building our scenes and objects. Let's get back to the LEGO example. When we start building something, we pick the brick with the right shape, but also with the right color. So we are building and coloring our creations at the same time, and we get a much better impression how the final creation will look like. That's why in the Cubic Worlds course, we will learn a workflow where we build and color our objects at the same time, so we see how the final result will look like while we are building it. So this all sounds super simple, right? Well, some areas of the course are, but others require a bit more intermediate knowledge about Blender. Especially when it comes to the more advanced chapters later in the course about character creation, rigging, and animation. So it is important that you know your way around Blender already. This here is not a beginner's course. So I assume that you have a basic understanding of Blender already, like user interface, navigation, working with 3D objects, modeling in edit mode, and also working with materials. If you're completely new to Blender, I highly recommend to at least watch my free Blender Beginners course, or in best case, my comprehensive Blender Launchpad course first. Then you should be prepared for this exciting Cubic Worlds journey. Okay, what will we actually learn in this course? The course is separated into three main parts, and each part is divided into multiple chapters, but everything belongs to the same course, meaning you pay once and get all parts of the course. Depending on when you join the course, not all parts might be available from the start. Part 1 is the first we will publish, followed by part 2 and 3 a few months later. However, part 1 is already a full package. Here we will learn the fundamental workflows which we will use to create all of our Cubic World scenes and recreate a full Cubic World scene from scratch. From coming up with the idea over to building and animating the scene, everything is explained thoroughly in a step-by-step approach. We even included a bonus chapter where we go over some basic video editing, and my colleague Richard Albert, who is a composer and sound designer, will teach you how to add music and sound effects to your 3D animations. So you really learn everything from the very start to the very end on creating a full 3D animation which you can share with the world. After finishing part 1 of the Cubic Worlds course, you should be able to create basically any Cubic Worlds scene you can imagine, which does not contain any animated or rigged characters, machines and so on. This will be covered in part 2. Here we will learn how to create characters, rig and animate them, and we will also learn how to create and rig and animate machines like robots or vehicles, or a mixture of both. In the final part 3, we will break down some more complex Cubic Worlds scenes. Here we won't recreate these scenes from scratch, but I give you a summary of what workflows I use to create them. This will give you additional inspiration, ideas and insights on what you can do with a Cubic Worlds style and workflows. That means the further we progress in the course, the less step-by-step based it becomes, since at some point it's just the repetition of the basic fundamental workflows which we have learned in the first chapters, and then just extending our knowledge with more specialized workflows. In terms of tools, we will only use Blender, which is completely free, and a few free add-ons. We don't use any paid add-ons or tools in this course. For better accessibility, the videos of the course are short and fun, mostly ranging between 5 and 10 minutes. We have English captions for each and every video, and the entire course can be streamed online in up to 4K resolution and be fully downloaded in 2K resolution. Also, all project files are attached to the lessons, so you can download them and practice and learn with these files. Also, if you have any questions down the road, you can ask them in the discussion section underneath each video, or in our CG Boost community. My team and I are there to help you, and we have a lot of helpful people in the community. And if you're not sure if the course is right for you, we have a full 30 days money back guarantee, so no risk on your side if you don't enjoy the course. So if you feel ready to get on your very own Cubic Worlds journey, I see you on the other side.